Each airport in the national airspace system has unique and distinct characteristics, which can sometimes lead pilots to use the wrong surface in taxi, takeoff, or landing operations. Let's take a look at some of these tricky areas from the flight deck. Reno Tahoe International, KRNO, is a medium-sized, multi-use airport located on the southeast edge of the city of Reno, Nevada. Traffic mix consists of everything from small, backcountry-capable airplanes all the way to heavy military transports. Pilot experience levels that vary from the beginning student pilot all the way to seasoned airline captain, along with the diverse aircraft and traffic mix, makes Reno a challenging airport environment for pilots and controllers alike. The airport also experiences a major increase in traffic during the annual Burning Man Festival. The airport configuration consists of parallel runways 17 left and right, 35 left and right, and intersecting runway 826. The taxiway system provides access to all parking areas and services located on the northeast, northwest, and southwest quadrants of the airport. This includes dual parallel full-length taxiways located on the west side of the airport, adjacent to runway 17 right, 35 left. The airport is surrounded by higher terrain in all directions and has its own Class Charlie airspace. Before departing for Reno, pilots should make themselves aware of both of these factors and clearly understand the requirements and challenges associated with each. At any airport with parallel runways with staggered thresholds, wrong surface landings are a potential issue. At Reno, this is no different. This situation occurs most often with aircraft assigned and cleared to land on runway 35 right. The surrounding terrain often distracts pilots and leads them to turn their base turn earlier than they might normally would. This makes runway numbers difficult to see, potentially contributing to the pilot fixating on the more dominant runway, 35 left. Adding to this problem is that the terrain often makes it difficult for controllers in the tower to recognize misaligned aircraft. To help mitigate this issue, the tower operates the runway end identifier lights, or reels, for runway 35 right when that runway is in use. Some pilots utilize the eastern section of the McCarran Loop, a road that surrounds the airport and city environment, as a guideline for the right downwind and base leg entries. However, utilizing the road during the base leg can be deceiving, as it directs the pilot toward runway 35 left. ATC often instructs aircraft inbound from the west to cross midfield and make right traffic for runway 35 right. The McCarran Loop creates a tempting guideline for this maneuver, but pilots need to be cautious as to not be guided to runway 35 left if they were cleared for runway 35 right. To enhance situational awareness for areas where runway confusion may lead to a wrong surface event, where a pilot may approach or land on the incorrect runway, taxiway, or wrong airport, the FAA is releasing arrival alert notices at several airports with a history of misalignments. Arrival alert notices, a tool for pre-flight planning, provide a graphic visually depicting the approach to a particular airport with a history of misalignment risk. There is also language describing the potential confusion. This airport has an arrival alert notice, which can be found in the digital chart supplement under Airport Remarks, which will then point you to the Special Notices section. The dual parallel full-length taxiways, located on the west side of runway 17 right, 35 left mentioned earlier, can also add to potential confusion. Taxiway Bravo has been mistaken for runway 35 left, thus leading the pilot to think they are lined up for runway 35 right, when in fact they are aligned for runway 35 left. Being aware of configuration issues at Reno will help pilots make better decisions and, along with the ATC tower, keep the operation safe and efficient. We hope this short video helps you prepare for your trip to the Reno Tahoe International Airport. It's always better to know before you go.